Let us now discuss the mean life of a radioactive element. We already studied that we can write as radioactivity is a random process. Some nuclei, if we talk about a sample of a radioactive element, some nuclei decay in beginning and some decay after a long time. So in this situation, we can say those nuclei which decay in beginning, we can say that these nuclei have a short lifespan or short lifetime as parent nuclei, and those nuclei which decay after a long time, we can say that these nuclei have long lifetime. So in all, we can say in a random process, as nuclei continuously decay, few have short lifetime, few have long lifetime. So different nuclei in the sample have different lifetime for which it exists as a parent nuclei. So here, as we are studying about mean life of a radioactive element, we can define the mean life of a radioactive element, which is denoted by Tm. This can be written as the way how we calculate the mean of different quantities as a sum of lives of all nuclei in a sample divided by the total number of nuclei in that sample. So the ratio of sum of the lives of all nuclei to the total number of nuclei gives us the mean life. This cannot be directly calculated as the process is random. So it can be calculated, the sum of lives of all the nuclei can be calculated by the laws of probability. Right now I am not calculating it separately. In the next section, so we'll see how it can be calculated. So on after calculation analysis, when we find the result, this comes out to be equals to the reciprocal of the decay constant of the element. And here we can see this will be a constant for every element, but it will be different for every element. This will be constant for each and every element, but that will be different for different elements. So this remains a constant. This is quite an important term you need to keep in mind, which gives us the idea about the stability also. As if lambda is low, the value of mean life is high. That means most of the nuclei in the sample have large lifetime, so the nucleus is relatively stable, and vice versa also.